morning, and welcome to the Church of St. Patrick. Today we celebrate the first Sunday of Advent. Our second collection is to help support the maintenance of our parish facilities. Please take a bulletin home with you weekly. It lists all our upcoming parish activities for the month. Advent is a time of waiting for Christ, allowing Jesus to be reborn in our lives. It is also a time for purifying our hearts by repentance and for renewing our lives by reflecting on and experiencing the several comings or advents of Christ into our lives. Besides his first coming and his birth, Jesus comes to our lives through the sacraments, through the Word of God, to the worshiping community at the moment of our death, and finally in his second coming to judge the world. We remember at this Mass the people of the parish. Our gathering hymn is hymn number 362, Behold, O Zion, God will come. Hymn number 362. Please stand and join us in.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds and his coming, so that, gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. This is what Isaiah, son of Amoz, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest mountain and raised above the hills. All nations shall stream toward it. Many peoples shall come and say, "Come, let us climb the Lord's mountain to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may instruct us in his ways, and we may walk in his paths. For from Zion shall go forth instruction, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations and impose terms on many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. One nation shall not raise a sword against another, nor shall they train for war again. O house of Jacob, come. Let us walk in the light of the Lord." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you know the time. It is the hour now for you to awake from sleep, for our salvation is nearer now than when we first believed. The night is advanced, the day is at hand. Let us then throw off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us conduct ourselves properly as in the day, not in orgies and drunkenness, not in promiscuity and lust, not in rivalry and jealousy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the desires of the flesh. The word of the Lord.
Said to his disciples, as it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. In those days, before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, up to the day that Noah entered the ark. They did not know until the flood came and carried them all away. So will it be also the coming of the Son of Man. Two men will be out in the field, one will be taken and one will be left. Two women will be grinding at the mill, one will be taken and one will be left. Therefore, stay awake, for you do not know on which day your Lord will come. Be sure of this: if the master of the house had known the hour of the night when the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake and not let his house be broken into. So too, you also must be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come. The Gospel of the Lord. Some small transformations have taken place here in the church. No longer green vestments, but the purple vestments of Advent. No longer a lot of flowers or plants, but the simple wreath of the Advent wreath and the green of the giving trees. These small changes indicate that we're in a new season, a new spiritual season, the holy season of Advent. While transformations take place in the church, the real work of Advent is the transformation that takes place in our heart. Our readings today talk about this transformation, this deep spiritual transformation that we're called to. The first reading from the book of Isaiah, this really is lyrics to a song. Scriptures tell us that the people in Israel would sing this song. They would sing it out loud. And they would talk, and in this song, talk about a transformation. God, you will lead us back home, away from captivity, back to our homeland. We can't wait for that to happen. And so they would sing this song of transformation, of change, of going back home. And that God would make this happen. And they would be transformed into the people of God, worshiping, praying, and singing to God always. In this transformation of the people of the Old Testament, it wasn't just for the Israelites, but they, in their song, they saw the bigger picture, that God is coming to change, and he would make a big change. And so they dreamt big. Imagine a world where there's no wars. And so we heard them say, they will take their spears and their arrows, and they will melt them down, and they will make plows. They will make instruments for farming because there's no more war. Imagine a time where there's no more war on the face of the earth. This is what they imagined. This is what they prayed for, this transforming effect of God in our lives. When we open ourselves up to the presence of God and ask to make this big dream a reality, where we are called to live in peace, harmony. And not just for the Israelites, but all nations will come streaming to the Lord because they'll want this peace. They'll want this transformation. They'll want God's justice to take root in our lives. Our second reading continues this theme of transformation. St. Paul is speaking to the Romans when he says, this transformation will be like putting on new clothes. You know that feeling? We got a new clothes and we wear it for the first time, we feel great. And so St. Paul is saying, this transformation of the Lord is like putting on some new clothes. We talk about that in the sacrament of baptism. We dress the baby in white. They put on the white garment of Christ. They put on Christ himself. And a transformation takes place. We begin to live like Jesus, serve like Jesus in our world. And Jesus, St. Paul reminds the Romans and us that the real transformation is the change of the essence of our personhood. Not just clothes, but what that symbolizes, that we, inside our heart, will be transformed, will be changed, will become the true disciples of Jesus. What will that look like? Look like people being kind to one another, by people serving and caring for one another, by people bringing mittens and scarves to poor children who can't afford it, to bringing items on our giving tree for expectant parents to help them through anyone who's going through a difficult time and can't afford it, and they would be there to serve, to help. This is the transformation that Jesus is talking about. Changing something in our heart. That when we see someone in need, we respond with generosity, with kindness, and with peace. Jesus in the Gospel today, our third reading, the Gospel reading, talks about this transformation. This transformation isn't one to be afraid of at the end of the world, but the transformation is to be one that transforms us into God's people. It transforms us to making his kingdom come right here, right now, through our works of charity, kindness, and love for one another. As we celebrate and begin this holy season of Advent, let us pray for that transformation that the Word of God calls us to turn our lives towards Jesus, to imitate him the best way we can, serve him on our heart, mind, and soul. May the Lord bless us on our Advent journey to the stable on Christmas Day. time now we'll have the blessing of the Advocate. Please be seated. Christ came to bring salvation and has promised to come again. Let us pray that we may be always ready to welcome him.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That the keeping of Advent may open our hearts to God's love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the light of Christ may penetrate the darkness of sin, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this wreath may constantly remind us to prepare for the coming of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Christmas season may fill us with peace and joy as we strive to follow the example of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth your blessing upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May their light reflect the splendor of Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless this wreath in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us prepare for the offertory.
Please join in singing our preparation hymn, number 635, Rejoice the Lord is King, hymn number 635.
Thank you.
my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we made, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design from long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. He went about to give his life to set us free. As he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. Graciously to endow us with his very spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis our Pope, Alfred our Bishop, and all the bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, Saint Patrick, and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer some sign of that peace to those around us. sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Glory to God, our Lord, that you shall remember, but only say the word.
Join in singing our communion hymn number 344, O Lord of Light, hymn number 344.
The body of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and to hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. A couple brief announcements for our parish family. We will celebrate Advent Vespers this afternoon at 4 o'clock. All are welcome. These are the same Vespers that are prayed around the world, and we will share with that. It's a great way to enter into the spirit of the season of Advent. So please consider joining us at 4 o'clock this afternoon here at church. Our giving tree in the back of the church is sponsored by Catholic Charities. It's once again collecting items for pregnant or parenting families. Please take a tag off the tree in the back of church. A new tree has been added to our church. I was working with the 8th graders in the prep program, and this is our winter tree. Got to use your imagination a little bit. But we're inviting, the 8th graders are inviting all children or anybody in our parish to bring in small mittens or hats or scarf for children. And these will go to special places throughout the city to help those who are in need. So items for small children. Just bring it in before Mass. Place it on any of the branches. Do not climb the tree. Children are invited to leave a pair of shoes at the statue of St. Nicholas next weekend. They can pick up their shoes the following weekend with a surprise in them. The next First Saturday Mass will be held on Saturday, December 3rd, this coming Saturday at 8 a.m. Our next spaghetti dinner is next Sunday, December 4th. Please join us. Tickets of chance will not be sold in church during the Advent season as we make our focus in caring for the needy and the poor and the coming of Jesus at Christmas time. Tickets for the $10,000 shamrock can be picked up in the parish office. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This Mass is ended. Let us go in God's peace.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael,
recessional hymn number 743, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling, hymn number 743.